I promise I'm not wearing like a solid black shirt. You guys, it's too close for you guys to tell the difference. Greetings and salutations, everybody. Hey girl, hey, what's up? Today I wanted to do a little mini Kosas wear test because they recently released their new Revealer Concealer, which retails for $28. Claims to be super creamy, brightening, comes in 16 different shades, and a lot of people have been talking about it. My shade was sold out like almost instantly, so now that's restocked, I picked one up to try. And I also wanted to test out award-winning from Allure 2019. This is the Kosas Tinted Face Oil, and she's supposed to be amazing. We'll also be wearing one of their cheek duos. This is the Velvet Melon. I've worn this before on my channel a couple of times, and this was the first product I purchased from their brand. They also have lip products now, and I think they're best known for either their face oil or this cheek duo prior to the concealer being released. So we're gonna put all that on the face. My eyes and eyebrows are already done. Both the concealer and the face oil come in 16 different shades. We've already talked about the price point and the claims of the concealer. We'll dive a little deeper in a second. But the face oil is $42. She holds a real high price tag. Supposedly it's worth it, and we're gonna find out. Full disclosure though, I did try to film this like 2 days ago. The footage, the camera setting wasn't right. I wasn't loving it. So we're gonna redo it. We didn't really get past like the beginning starting point picture, so I don't really know how it wears yet. But I do know how it applied. I have a feeling it's probably Kosas, not Kosas. So if I say it like oddly the whole video, I apologize. Naturally I say Kosas, but I'll try to say Kosas. If you do not know much about this brand, they are one of the Sephora green clean beauty brands. So they're vegan, cruelty-free, gluten-free. And this is a product that has a really good dropper bottle in my opinion. So the dropper doesn't look too special, but it works well. You don't need a lot, which I didn't realize till after the fact the first time I tried to apply this. It's just a few drops. And what I mean by this dropper works well, it literally deposits all you need. Like, it's not gonna like overflow out, and it keeps it really clean and tidy. I wasn't expecting, I don't know if it has to do with this design, because you can see the bottle is actually kind of squished inwards. That's just naturally how it sits. It's not that it pops back out with air, it just sits like that. So whatever magic's going on in this bottle, I like it. I'm just gonna put out a few drops. Let's do 8 even. I love 8. It's advised to use your fingers. I'm not the biggest fan of finger application, but as far as a brush that works well for replicating that fingertip pushing would be this NYX high glass brush. I really like it. It's dirty right now, but she really pushes that product in. So I think this works very well as an alternative for those who don't want to use your hands, especially like with everything going on right now and the craziness. You don't want to be touching your face if you don't have to, right? I love my phalanges. I love the whole natural God-given makeup application tools. I prefer a brush. So we're gonna dab into this. Push this on. As far as the shades I am using, I'm using number 5, tone 5, which is a medium with golden. And then the concealer is in tone 4, which is a light with golden. And it's not the most dramatic under eye, but it is not the same. Because like, they're 5 in concealer and 5 in foundation is the same. So I wouldn't wear 5. You could go lighter if you wanted a dramatic under eye, but I do think it gives me a good brightening effect without being like, whoa, wham, bam, because I feel, maybe I'm wrong, the type of person who would want to wear this product, or when you are wearing this product, you're not trying to go for like huge bright under eyes, but you want it to look, you know, not like dark circles, a little better. You want that concealing, subtle brightening. So I think those shades would be perfect for my twinsies. As you can see, I'm moving this product around. She is dewy. That's something I had a problem with my camera beforehand. Aside from the fact that it wasn't on the best focus setting for this type of product, because when it's like super reflective, it's like, are you blurring? Or like, are you wet? Like, what's going on? And this is a dewier finish, but I try not to apply too much this time. It claims light coverage. I think she's medium until you set her. With my skin type, it's probably not the best not to set this because it's so hydrating. This is like the most dewy finish face oil, skincare or makeup wise I've ever tried. But when you set it, you kind of lose coverage because the powder absorbs some of that product, and then you see more of your acne scars coming through. So I don't know what I want to do this time. I do feel like I need to at least set like my nose and maybe just start my T-zone and let everything else be, because when I set my cheeks last time, I was like, oh, that's not what I wanted, you know? So this is about 4 drops because I took about half of the circle. They claim that this application only takes 16 seconds and that their 16 shades can work for 48 different skin tones. They say they're flexible. They adjustable. For light coverage, you use 2 to 4 drops for just a light layer. If you want to use more, then you intensify by 2 to 4 drop increments. And if you want to spot conceal, they say like 2 drops and just pat, pat, pat. So it is very flexible as far as the coverage, especially if you find one of those tones work really well for you. And it's a really flattering formulation. I'm gonna leave it alone because if I mess with it too much, I think it's gonna streak. So this is what my face looks like without any product on it. And here is the side with the product on it. I think it looks way more healthy. With the shirt that I'm wearing right now, you're not getting any of like the color from my shoulder out, which matches this very, very well. My neck is pale. My face is pale in comparison to my body. But just trust me when I say that between 4 and 5, which are my only options, 4 would only be good for me when I'm at my palest for maybe a few months out of the year. The majority of the year, 5 would make more sense. Of course, you could always mix both, but I mean, I don't think 5 is bad, and I think it's the best choice for me. The undertones are great. Talking about undertones, as far as this concealer goes, a lot of people complain that the whole line ran yellow. As a yellow tone gal, I'm not too mad at it, but I do understand the concern, and this like rarely happens, but that was like something across the board that everyone felt like even the colors that weren't supposed to be yellow were pretty yellow on them. I don't think I'm gonna have that problem because that's all I ever want in life. But let's finish up this side of the face. So Kosas, their aim is to meet skincare with makeup. So a lot of their products are very nourishing, and I believe because of their cleaner formulations, that's where their price tag comes from. It's not crazy for Sephora, but I will say this product reminds me a lot of the Glossier skin tint. I've reviewed that on my channel as well, but this one does feel more nourishing. It has the same consistency, more coverage by far, because that thing is the thinnest formulation I've ever tried in my entire life, as well as it should be. For someone who wants something very lightweight that doesn't feel like a foundation, feels more like a skincare, and you can also mix this in with your moisturizer or primer or anything else if you don't want to wear too many things. This is a mixer. I think this would be great for those who just don't want too much, and I can see how that appealed to the masses and enough to get it a Allure award, because she's really giving you coverage, she's giving you radiance. I mean, this isn't for my gals who are severely oily. I don't think it should be for you. Not saying we can't wear face oils, I just don't think you can wear this product because it is very, very dewy. And if it's set differently, I would probably change my mind, but because I know how it sets, it might not give you what you want for very long. But it still gives me like, hey, you wearing like tinted moisturizer, at least. You know, you wearing something. I'm not saying what's your skincare routine. I'm gonna say, what are you using on your face, you know? The amount of product in this bottle would last you a while. And there we are, all set. So let's move on to Miss Revealer. For the most part, this creamy brightening concealer was a hit off the jump. That's why it sold out so fast. I think it is reasonably priced. You get a good amount of product for $28, specifically 8 milliliters, which some $30 concealers have a little less than that. So tone 4 is described as a light with golden undertones, and that is what we will be applying. So from what I learned, this is a concealer that you should let do its thing before you blend it out. Otherwise, you won't get the medium coverage it claims to have. This has a flexible doe foot that really flexes and deposits, as you can see. So I'm just gonna put this right there and let it hang. It isn't a concealer that you need to rush to blend. Again, let it just chill. You don't have to double dip, really. It has so much on the doe foot already. I think that was already too much. But I'm gonna put this around this red area too. And this will give you that medium coverage. If you blend it out instantly, you'll get very light coverage. It has a radiant finish. It claims to be more of a cream than a liquid. I think just from my 2 application experiences with it, this would be great to contour with. If you see a color that you want to get for that, I would say jump on it because it's so forgiving. Reminds me a little bit of the Too Faced Multi-Sculpt Concealer, which I am a fan of. So for the ingredients in this, the key ingredients that they advertise, I am familiar with all 3. So the first one is Arnica. Arnica is what I took when I was recovering from either any bruising or swelling, whether it be from my filler, they give you that after filler, or after any sort of bruising experience. Like, it's given a lot in the medical field because it's a homeopathic ingredient that really promotes anti-inflammation and your natural healing process. So they also feature caffeine, which you see in a lot of under eye products, and this is more advertised as that under eye concealer. So caffeine really helps like deal with that, you know, crevice you get under your eyes, kind of plump it up. It gives that effect. You see it in a lot of eye patches, a lot of eye creams. And the last key ingredient would be peptides, which is something you hear a lot when it comes to products with collagen. It helps boost that skin's natural collagen. So really work as a skincare ingredient to help with your under eyes. Not color, but actual like skin, the texture, the appearance, the lines, the puffiness, or the depth underneath it. That's what this is aimed to do. So that's where that skincare comes in. And Arca's that gal. Trust me, she's amazing. So I'm gonna get to blending now. Since we've talked enough, we've let her do her thing. And as you can see, it is brighter in that area, but just very subtly. But if you wanna go, you know, more dramatic, you can go up a click or two, to each their own. Or if you're not even interested in the face oil, then yeah, get whatever shade you want, girl. Online though, because you know, we all stay in it right now, online. Out of all the shades, tone 4, the one I'm using, was the one that sold out right away. And I was like, guys, leave me one, please. And there you go. She looks really smooth. She looks really radiant, as it claims to be. As you can see in the up-close cam footage, I'm having some sort of, I'm just aware of it right now, situation, because I had like a little bit of a blackhead there the other day. It's probably just healing now because the blackhead has already come out of the skin. And the skin's just kind of, you know, like flaking around that area. It's not like the best situation, but there's a lot of motion around that area with my mouth. So that's there. That's life. What's new? Skin can't be perfect. But you can see how the face oil is sitting on it. It's not the worst. It's not accentuating it, but I do think that flake will probably flake off throughout the day. That's my guess. So this finish isn't for everyone. This is like totally L'Oreal Pro Glow on the face. I actually really like Pro Glow, but that's to each their own, especially when you go into that combo oily skin type. It's not for everybody. This is not semi-matte. This is not what you're getting at all in this video. And I know a lot of people are looking for that M word. So they have not released a powder of any sort yet within the line. They have the concealer, the face oil, their lip oil, the cheek duos, and some other lip products. That's all they have right now. Again, very like starter Glossier stages as well. So that's why I really think of the comparison between the two brands. Obviously Glossier is a lot more affordable. And if you want to see that video, it'll be in the cards. I think I need to do a part 2 to that because they've released a lot more and we should do another one. I do want to set my under eyes because as radiant as they look, they do feel more like creamy there, like I can feel it compared to the rest of my face. So I'm gonna use the Pat McGrath under eye powder. I just did a review video on that. She's really simple, really lightweight, and I think that's all we need right now is a lightweight gal. So I'm just gonna lightly put her there. It's looking good. You can really see the difference head on between the set side and the not set side. The face oil that's in my neck area doesn't feel too bad. I mean, we'll see if it ends up like causing any issues throughout the day. I'm gonna take the same brush and wipe this down the bridge of my nose for that brightening effect, but also to set that nose because I do get so oily. A little bit right here so the concealer doesn't move. And then just around that brow. For those asking, this is Valair. I love their brushes. I mention it all the time. And I believe this is the F05 brush from them. So the concealer is set. I'm gonna leave the cheeks be because we're gonna put cheek product on top of it anyway. So we're just in that upper area. The highlight might cause a little commotion, but hopefully not too much because this is a really thin powder. Into my precious Velvet Melon. Well loved. I adore both the highlight and the cream shade. And I do actually use this with my fingers. Pat it in. I just find that to be the best application with this formula. Just on the cheek, we need to put a little bit of the color going back towards the hairline. Otherwise, you won't really get that blush effect. It's a tackier formulation, like, because it is a cream. A very popular one, though. So they have two different intensities. I have the one that's not high intensity because I didn't love, I want to say, the blush in that one because they basically intensify both sides. And now for our highlight, a little bit on the bridge of the nose. I'll blend with a different finger. Just for some dimension, just right where my nose bends. A little bit on the upper lip, and we'll clean off the lips afterwards. We're gonna try our best to highlight, also without stabbing myself in the eye. So I apply it with one finger and then I press it in with a different one, so it's not like too much product. She's subtle, she's not high intense. Whatever's left on my finger will go just at the bottom of my chin. Just for very subtle dimension. I think this is really it for the base, guys. I'm gonna try to leave the rest of my face be. Not touch it too much, obviously, throughout the day, because we don't wanna do that right now. I'm going to finish up the rest of my face. I'm gonna take it really easy with the lips, just a little mascara on the lower lash line. I was waiting to be able to kind of just finish that up to complete the look. We're going like really, really soft. Not too much color, neutral glam, because, you know, ain't really much to do right now. But I wanted to try out these new lashes too. These are by Velour. It's one of their effortless sets. So like already pre-trimmed, I don't gotta cut it. I just put the glue on my lash line and really easy. So these are in Would I Lie? Would I Lie? Alrighty, so that is it for now. I'm gonna give you guys the starting point pictures, the close-up cam footage, and see you guys at the end of the day, and we will see how this looks, if it's on there, if we survive. So we're back and it's 11:18 right now. It's been a day. I've been looking like this, all of this, while packing, yeah. Doing homework with my kids because, you know, schools are closed right now. I haven't had any chances to really look at my face. I didn't really pass by nothing. I ain't even glanced when I was in the bathroom. So let's see what happened. Picture. So as expected, our little circly patch, my little imperfection over here, he's looking a little drier, a little flakier, a little bit more known. I mean, he was already visible in the beginning, but it has increased visibility. My face doesn't feel super lightweight, but I don't think it feels heavy. I think we're in that like average middle cusp. I don't think I'm like, oh, cake. But I didn't forget that I was wearing makeup at all. I think if I wasn't wearing concealer or anything else, if it was just the face oil, maybe. I am pleasantly surprised that I'm not dripping in grease right now. Yes, my lips are peeling and like drier. Let's not talk about it right now, okay? That's not what we're here for. So I didn't end up touching my face at all. I'm touching it now, which I hate myself for. But it doesn't feel like an oil slick. That's nice. My neck doesn't feel bad. Just a shocker. I definitely look a little bit more hydrated and that, like, you know, the makeup has settled into my skin a little more. But the only thing that has a little bit of shine is the very, very tip, like next to my dot of my nose. Just a very small circumference. That's it. Right now, everything else feels really good. I can still feel the cream blush and highlight right here that has its own little texture. Otherwise, if I didn't wear those, I think we would feel pretty much 99%. I don't know how else to say it, but like dry. AKA not greasy, not dry like flaking though. So I'm gonna assume that the skincare portion of this formulation really did its job. My skin liked it, it didn't break me out. I don't think it settled too well around my dry areas, which is surprising to me. It's like under the lip, which has quite a bit of texture right now. But on like a normal day to day, this would probably be the condition of my skin. And it didn't love that area too much. I don't think it is bad product, and I'm speaking about the face oil. I would probably give it another shot and wear it for those situations where I'm like, oh, like I just don't wanna do too much. But it isn't my favorite formulation. I do think it is pretty consistent as far as how much coverage it gives you. It's light, medium at best, but don't expect any sort of anything else from it. If it's light most days, it's probably gonna be light on you most days. So I would give the tinted face oil the grade of a B. It isn't amazing me right now, so it doesn't get anywhere near an A. I considered the B plus, but because of how it's settling on these drier areas, and that's very surprising to me, it's just gonna get a B. And if it was any worse, it would get to that B minus. It wasn't too bad around my nose. It doesn't love my little whiteheads and such, but it didn't flake or peel. Otherwise, a B minus would have been up its alley real quick. Concealer time. The Revealer. Is that what it's called? It is called the Revealer Concealer. I don't hate it, but I'm not in love with it because I can definitely see my under eye bags right now. You can see where they start. You really can. So I don't feel like the coverage is gonna work for someone like me. If your under eyes aren't that bad and you just like a light to medium coverage concealer, then sure, give this a shot. I don't need a full coverage, like that's not my preference, but if it starts a little better than this, which I think it did for the medium it gave us, and it wears down at all, this isn't even worth it to me. Look how tired I look, like for real. It was way smoother in the beginning, so I do think it lost a little bit of coverage throughout the day, down a whole click from medium to light. It is comfortable. I don't see any excess creasing. I just see more of my dark circles peeking through than I would like to, and that's the most distracting part. So otherwise, I would say the formulation isn't bad, and I see where they're going with it with the skincare ingredients, as I mentioned earlier, and the price point's pretty reasonable. The color worked out well. I don't regret it. Nothing oxidized on me today. Everything stayed what it was in the beginning. I don't think I'm singing praises for this formulation though on myself. So just from my experience, as I always grade from, she's also gonna get a B because it could be worse. It really could. It could have been creasing, it could have been flaking, it could have been unflattering from the jump. So a B she will get. That's with the price and the shade selection and all that included. Oh yeah, the cheek product, the cheek duo. I think I've graded it before, so I don't think I'll grade it today. If you guys want to check out the video where I first used it, I'll link it off. Let me know down below what you think about these products, if you're trying either of them. If you have tried them already, let me know about your experience. That is it for me today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed seeing my experience. If you're interested in seeing any of my recent uploads, they're on the screen right now, as well as a subscribe button here and down below. Feel free to click either of them if you haven't yet, because it's free 99 and I'd love for you to join our fam and stick around a little longer, watch a few more videos, see my next upload. That is it for me today. I'll see you guys in a later video. While I put my lashes away, if you guys are interested, I finally made a TikTok, so go ahead and give it a follow if you guys want to support your girl.